Hello people, my name is Shruti and I want to inform you that soon a new Elementor layout is coming to you if you use Elementor or Elementor Pro. It's already available, so I will show you how to get the new layout, and it can be that when you have the new layout you're like, this is quite different, where is this option? And that's why I made this video. I will tell you where that option is. Wow, isn't that beautiful? If you can appreciate that, then please like the video. Now let's get started. First, let me show you how to get the new layout. Right now, if I edit this page with Elementor and the other one, which is identical, it looks like this. If I want to save it or update it, I can click over here. And here are a few options. But with the new layout, that will not be the case anymore. If you want to update it, let's go to the second website. I go to the dashboard by clicking here. Then I go to Elementor. Settings, features. Then I scroll down and I search for editor top bar. It's an alpha. They're still working on it. Then it will go in beta. Then it will be released. So I click on activate or active. I scroll down and I save the changes. And now when I go to the same website, I click on edit with Elementor. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the new layout. And with a lot of things in life, change can be a little bit hard. I had a few times already the last 5-6 years, like Elementor did something. I was like, what? Why? And later on, I thought, hey, it actually makes sense. It's the same with this. So let's go to the old layout. It looks like this. And the new layout looks like this. And it will make your whole process in making websites better. So let me walk you through the options. Over here, I can update it if I want to change something. I can click on update and it will be updated. Over here, when I change something, I need to do it over here. And it says publish instead of update, but it means the same. You're updating your page. Then the old layout. If you want to check what you've done, you can click over here. Or you can click on the eye and then in the new tab. And then you see your new design. With the new layout, it's this eye over here. So they're both close to each other and that's what I like. So those two are covered. Now let's go to another feature over here. If I want to save this as a template, this whole page, I click over here on this arrow up, save as a template. With the new version, it's the arrow down here at the right top corner, save as a template. If I want to take a look at the layout on different devices, I click on this icon over here, responsive mode, and there you have it. Three options. And with the new layout, it's already on top. Why? All the time, we need to make sure that our website is optimized for all devices. So we don't have to click first. Immediately, we have those options. Those options will be there always. As long as you are logged in, you will see this and this left area, unless you click over here. Then you still have those options over here. So I think that's nice. Now we need to click one time less. And if you make websites all day, in a few years, that will save you a few days. And then you can take those off, do something with people you love. Wow, they really thought this through. That they keep you and your families and your loved ones in mind when they make changes to Elementor. Let's give them a round of applause. Okay. Click here, click here, click here. That's it. Okay, the next one. If I want to go back, maybe I did something I don't want to do. I can click over here to the history, here at history, and I can put things back. Or I can go to the revisions tab and then I can bring it back to something I did 2 weeks ago or a year ago. All those revisions can be reached by clicking over here. With the new version, we click on the Elementor logo in the left-hand top corner. And then there is the history. Looks the same. There's also the revisions tab. So that's where you can find that. Let's go to the next one, which I really like. It's the navigator. It's already turned on, so I turn it off. I click on it again. And there it is. We can navigate through our pages. We can click over here, click on the container. So sometimes it's a little bit hard, especially when you have a complicated design to reach a certain element or a certain container. With a navigator, you can do that and it keeps everything organized. With the new layout, it's here. Click over here, you can turn it on, turn it off. And it has exactly the same functions as the other one. But here it's on the top at the left. Next one, the settings. If I go to the settings, I can change the site title, have an excerpt, etc. Over here, I go to this icon and there are the page settings. So here's the title, the excerpt, the featured image, etc. So over here on top, you can click over here and you can go to the recent pages. So before I worked on the layers page, the snow page. So in that way, it's nice to navigate between pages and look how fast that went. I go back to the homepage. Where was that? In the old layout. If you know if there was an option like that, I think there was not an option like that. So I'm happy with that. It's a new feature. I love new features and I hope you do too. And I hope you like this one. So we have covered those. So most of these are here on top. A few extra options. If you want to get help, click over here. You can search for anything. Containers. Using containers, etc. You can search over here and then go to the dashboard. If you want to, you can also say Command E and then go there, but it's the same with this area, Command E. So that's all. I always use the shortcut. I love it. When you are on any page, click on Command E. I want to go to the dashboard, click over here. There you go. What else? The old layout. If you want to go to the site settings, you can click on the three lines over here, go to the site settings, and then you can change the global colors, global fonts, etc. With the new layout, over here is the option site settings on the top. And there you have it, exactly the same stuff. Old layouts. We want to go to the preferences. So over here, I can duplicate it. If I don't want to have these options, I can go to the three lines, to the user preferences. I can remove those editing handles. And now when I hover over it, nothing happens. Or if you want to change the interface to a light one, well, with the new layout, go over here to the Elementor icon and go to the user preferences. And then you can do the same things. I was searching for this one for a really long time. Like, where is it? Well, really simple. Click on the logo. There you go. Want to go to the theme builder? Click on the three lines. Go to the theme builder. Want to go back? Close it. Over here, click on the logo, go to the theme builder, click over here. If you want to exit Elementor, you're done, you updated everything, you're over here. You click over here on the three lines and you click on exit. Over here, click on the Elementor logo, manage website, and then you go to the dashboard. If you want to create a new element, which I can assume that will happen now and then if you're using Elementor, you click on those 9 blocks and then you can add anything over here. With the new layout, click on the plus over here. So you're somewhere else or you're in the settings. You want to create a new one, click on the plus and there you go. So that covered it. I love it. I needed some time to get used to it, but now, especially since I'm making tutorials that I want to be watched by others in the future, I prefer to work with the new layout. I like it. It took some time to get used to it, but I hope you will like it too. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please like it and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming tutorials about WordPress, WooCommerce, affiliate marketing, and more stuff. Have a great day and bye bye.